So as far as our introduction is concerned, we finish the teaching of, about that. But I wrote a little more for your thought, for your food of thought. You know, you can read and try to understand. So we go to the next topic. No. Still, we have the two kinds of truths. No, there are two kinds of truths we call conventional truth and samuti satya in Pali. So, no, we cannot dismiss the conventional truth. And this conventional truth, no, the conventional realities, no, are taken to really exist. Not like man, woman, not all the things they really exist. If we not so in the conversation, and then in the communication with each other, we have to use the conventional, not our conventional realities. So if you say, no, if there are not men, I, you do not exist, then not, you, somebody would commit murder. It's saying that, oh, I kill no person. So now we have to have the law, not to guard each person, and also we have not like the sons and daughters and the parents and teachers. So not the mother parents should bring up their children, and the children also when they grew up. They have to look after their parents. We have the duties, no? So like the teachers and son also like that. And then in the, we call that conventional truth. And then ultimate truth, no? The next one. So in ultimate truth, no? So only for the, no, the, for understanding of the real, no, the reality that really exists. So we take only ultimate realities, not to really exist in ultimate truth. And no, so in everyday life, though we use the conventional truth, conventional language, then we should understand not the ultimate, that the ultimate realities that we not just make up of mentality, materiality, when they are rising, perishing very, you know, quickly, and nothing is not permanent, so to get rid of the, like the, no, selfishness, all these things, you know. And then we have, you know, the elusive world and the real world. So I think I hear, you know, I described a little here. So, you know, we enjoy sense pleasure with, you know, also here also. You know, well, about enjoying the sense pleasure, the elusive world and the real world. So what we are seeing now is, now we say it is the elusive world. It is blinded by the ignorance, and we think that these people really exist. No, and then, no, the, in the elusive world, so no, though we people try to enjoy sense pleasure, they even think that enjoying sense pleasure is the real happiness in life. It is not the real happiness. No, it is elusive happiness, not the sensual pleasure. So I give you the example. In the Shakespeare's play, we have Romeo and Juliet, two young people. They fell in love, and they were very happy when they were in together. And they even said, "Oh, love is a, no, love is a." Many splendid thing, that's correct. No? Love is many splendid thing. But their parents disagree and separated them. Then when they were separated, they were very, very, no, very, very miserable. And finally they committed suicide. And you may also know that a very beautiful the movie actress, Marilyn Monroe. In the movie, we say the river of no return. No, she is very beautiful. No, so she was very successful. And amazingly, she also committed suicide. No? So no, the love, no, this, no, the sensual love and sensual pleasure are not real happiness. No? So I also try to tell you here. No? So like no, the many many millions billionaires, where they are, no? Many heartbroken lovers, no, committed suicide, and many billionaires also committed suicide during economic depression because, no, they invest their money in stocks and shares, and economic depression, the price of the stocks, no, went down very low. They lost many millions of dollars overnight. So as they are attached to this money, when they are lost, no, you get the great suffering, and they cannot bear the pain, and they committed suicide. And then we say, no, actually, greed, it is greed, no, not us, which craves for sensual pleasure. And when the desire or craving of greed is gratified, we feel happy with the illusion that we get what we want. But greed never gives away, no, its characteristic of craving. The more it gets, the more it craves for. And so we shall never be really happy, as ungratified desires mean suffering. No, so greed also, no, get the you can enjoy the movie just, no, by looking at the past time. After that, you don't want to watch for the second time. It always asks for the new things. So, and then we say that besides, we enjoy sense pleasure with, no, immoral minds rooted in greed, lopa, and ignorance, moha, which are the hottest fires. And they are also called defilements in Bali, we call kilesa. And they are the main causes of all suffering in the world. So they create the illusive world and enjoyment of sensual pleasure, and they will send us to woeful abodes of the dead. In reality, all living beings are made up of consciousness, chaita, mental factors, chaita seekers, and materiality, rupa. And inanimate things are made up of not only materiality, and all these ultimate realities are formless and shapeless. They are arising and perishing very rapidly, and so, no, they have the characteristic of impermanence, anicca. And what is impermanent and is, no, the is unsatisfactory? And to be tortured incessantly or continuously, you know, by the dissolution of this mentality and materiality really amounts to suffering dukkha. Moreover, as mentality materiality, you know, we call in Pali nama rupa, have no form, no shape, and they arise and perish extremely rapidly and incessantly, no person, no self, no soul, no ego, no jiva, no atta, and no creator really, or no permanent entity really exists. So this phenomena is called not self, anatta. So we should know that, no, all the ultimate realities, they have these three characteristics, no? Impermanence, the suffering, and not self. And also, the Buddha said, nobody is beautiful. So, no, if you take the Miss Universe, who is supposed to be the most beautiful lady in the world, so what we see her beauty is only the skin, not the skin, the outer skin of her. So if you, no, with your wisdom, if you peel up the outer skin of the Miss Universe, so the outer skin is very thin, actually. It will amount to only one handful, the skin. Smear with blood, smell very, no, very fishy. If you try to give the gentleman, this is the beauty of this universe. Now we will give you free. Who want to pay it? Nobody would take it. So now the Western people, they also said, they say, beauty is skin deep. No, so but in the next page, so they say beauty is skin deep. No, that's very correct. So no, thus all living beings and animal and animate beings have these characteristics of impermanence, anicca, suffering, dukkha, not self, anatta, and disgusting asupa. And this is the real nature of the real world. So in the real world, there are no living beings, no sense objects, no beautiful forms to be grateful for and to be attached to. And they are only formless. No? The ultimate reality is rising and perishing very rapidly under the universe, under universal law of cause and effect. So the Buddha also say when you have the craving. So from craving springs grief. No, you get the sorrow and the suffering from craving springs fear. No, because of thinking that you really exist. So you are afraid of death and afraid of danger, etc. And for those who is wholly free from craving and no grief, no, much less is fear. So that means, no, so in Vipassana meditation, we have to reflect on these four characteristics of materiality and mentality. So no, you can see it, no, by your wisdom. No, this the mental and material in that make of the body, they are rising very rapidly. So no, when you see that, you are convinced, oh, they are really, you know, what the Buddha said like that. So then you are not attached to yourself. You are not attached to anybody. So no, that means attachment is craving the same thing. No, you don't agree for anything. Then no, you will see that you will be very happy. Because no craving, no attachment, so nothing to worry. So you will be the happiest man. So by reflecting on these true characteristics, you know, the four characteristics of mentality, we can develop 10 insight knowledges, and also the four-part wisdom, the highest wisdom, and then you know, we can attain the highest attainment in life. That is we call the arahat, the arahatship. And then the next page, here. So no, we have the Venerable Kanti Siado. So no, he was the head of the monk in Myanmar. Abhidhamma Maharatha Guru is the highest, no, the highest title given to a monk. So his advice we should abide by. Seeing and knowing just conventional realities or concepts give one the wrong view and the wrong knowledge. Seeing and knowing ultimate realities give one the right view and the right knowledge. Concepts do not really exist. Only ultimate realities really exist. Speak in terms of concepts or conventional vocabularies with conventional vocabularies, but know in terms of ultimate realities. And this is the way how we should live. How we should live. So now we communicate with each other with conventional the vocabularies, but we should know the ultimate realities, you know, what is arising in us. Now we go to the chapter one. Now we can go to chapter one now. So we begin with consciousness. So you will have some idea, no? So though we say consciousness here, it is actually, no, they are describing the combination of consciousness and mental factors, and they really stand for the minds, not the minds, what we call. Now there are four classes of consciousness. No, citta is defined as consciousness, that is the consciousness of sense object or the awareness of sense object. So, no, depending on the four spheres, we might say, so we classify the consciousness in four ways here. Consciousness mostly experienced in the sense sphere, kama loka. We call kama vachara chaita. So kama loka, the sense sphere refers to the four woeful abodes and the human realm and the six deva realms. In all these realms, sensual pleasure is enjoyed. So we call them sensual sphere. So the first group. And consciousness mostly experienced in the fine material sphere, rupa loka. And we call it in Pali, rupa vachara chaita. And consciousness mostly experienced in the immaterial sphere, arupa loka. No? So arupa vachara chaita. So these two, the fine material sphere refers to the 16, the Brahma realms, populated by rupa Brahmas. So that is Brahmas with forms and bodies. And then the immaterial sphere refers to the four, the immaterial realms populated by arupa Brahmas. So Brahmas without forms and bodies. And then the fourth one is consciousness experienced in the supramundane level. We call them Logutra Chaita, supramundane consciousnesses. So, the realities, the Brahmas are more powerful than Devas, that we also call them deities. They enjoy greater peace and greater, the longer lives than Devas. So, then we go down. Sense the sphere consciousness, so we take this class, the consciousness that arises in us most of the time. So please go to the next page. So we have so in your book, we begin with the kama vajra. So here, in moral consciousness, the 54 kama vajra chaita. The first class here. There are 54 consciousnesses, and they are divided into three groups again, I think. In moral consciousness, we call in akusala chaita, there are 12 of them. And then we have the rupa vajra. It is rootless consciousnesses. So they are called ahetuka chaita. There are 18 of them. And then sense sphere, beautiful consciousness. So kama, sobana chaita, 24. Altogether, there are 54 chaitas. So you can show the chaita chart number one. So we give you the chart attached at the back. At the back of your book. Okay, this one. Okay. Now that the four spheres are classified like here. We call Kama Vajra Chaita 54. So up to here are Kama Vajra Chaita. So among these four, the kama vajra chaita, so we have three groups, 12 in moral minds, and 18, the rootless consciousnesses, consciousness without any roots. And then there are the 24 sense sphere beautiful consciousnesses. So the 12 in moral minds here are again classified into three groups. And then also the rootless consciousness also classified into three groups. And then 24 beautiful consciousness, they are also classified into three groups. And then we have 15, rupa vachara, consciousness, that is the five material sphere consciousnesses. No, they are the jhana chittas actually. So no, the 5, 5, 5, 15, and we have 12. No, in and the arupa vajra jhana, arupa vajra consciousnesses. So no, immaterial the consciousness. They are also the jhana chittas. And then we have no, the supramundane consciousness, Lokuttara Chaita. So in the brief method, there are 8 of them, consists of the 4 Lokuttara Kusala Chaita. They are actually the 4 Mega Chaita, no, the Mega, the part consciousness we call them. And then their fruition, we call Lokuttara Vipaka Chaita. So they are the 4 fruition consciousness here. No, and the wisdom associated with them are called the 4 part wisdom and the 4 fruition wisdom. No, they are the highest, no, the consciousnesses. So we will start with this, not immortal mind, 12 immortal minds. So we go to the book again. So the 12 immortal minds. No, they immoral means. So no, they are wicked consciousnesses. No, they are wicked one, the bad consciousnesses. And then no, people usually commit wicked and immoral deeds, no, evil deeds, with these immoral minds. So akusala chaita, bad result, and action is immoral. If it causes harm to any living being and produces bad effects to oneself and to others. And this definition should be noted. No, so in light, no, the philosophers, no, like Socrates, no, the Greek philosopher, no, they say, not to know what is good and what is bad in life is most important. Only if you know clearly, not the difference between the goodness and the evilness, he said, nobody would turn his back not towards the good and will follow the bad. Now the people, no, the Socrates himself, no, he admitted. No, the Greek the chronicle, no, they declare that, oh, Socrates is the wisest man in the art on earth, he said, no, the wisest man on earth. But the Socrates said, oh, all I know is that I know nothing, he said. I think that's correct, because he doesn't know any ultimate realities. He don't know any other way. So he know nothing actually. So to know, not to know the what is good and what is bad is not easy actually. So during Socrates' time, they have the sophists they call them. They are the chosen teachers, not the chosen teacher. They teach not the sons of the generals, etc. And then what they teach is what is good for you, what is beneficial for you is good. Now, what is not beneficial for you is bad. So that is the way we also try to regard it, and that is not the real way actually. No, for example, now if you are, you try say you are, you know, you say you sell something, and then when no, there are very little stock for that, and you increase the price, so you say it is good for me because I got, no, a lot of profit. But for the people, they have to, don't they? They have to pay more money, so for them it is not good. And though for you is you think it is good, because it is greedy, no? You commit this with greed-rooted consciousness, and then you develop bad karmas. So when you die, you will be born in a woeful state. So no, this is not good, not good for you and not good for others. And so now this is the way, no, the Buddha described what is good. So he said, no, so And action is, the various. So here, akusala chaita vebarisa. Here. And action is immoral. Immoral means evil or bad. So it is again morality. So it call it immoral. If it causes harm to any living being and produces bad effects to oneself and to others. Now when you steal something from others, you think it is good for you. But it is for him, he's what already bad. He had to suffer. And now, when you, by stealing, you commit the evil action and the bad, many billions of bad karma arise in you. And you have to suffer as the woeful ghost, Peter's, for many existences. So it's not good for you, actually. So if you know what is the immoral, you can say an action is moral or good if it causes no harm to any living being and produces good effects to oneself and to others. So now that's the way when we observe the Panchasila, moral precept. So the Buddha, he advised his son Rahula, who became a novice at the age of 7 years. 7 years. He made his son a novice. So he taught his son. So he said, "My son, what is the use of a mirror?" He said, "Oh, we can see the fault in our face by looking in the mirror." Okay, just remember. If you want to not to think, to speak, or to do something, see first where it will cause any harm to any living being. If it will cause harm, don't do it. Now, if it does not cause any harm, you do it. But while you are doing, you stop and again see whether it causes any harm to any living being. If it causes any harm to any living being, you stop it. Never do it again, he said. But if it does not cause any harm to anyone, you continue. When you finish, you look again. So, only if it causes any harm to any living being, don't do this thing anymore. So, only if it does not cause any harm, then you do it again and again. I think that's the best way. If we, everybody, will abide by this rule, we can enjoy the personal happiness, community happiness, and also the world peace. We can get world peace immediately, actually. Okay, now we have 12 immoral minds, so we call them the greed-rooted consciousness. So remember, we told you the lobha, dosa, moha, immoral roots. They give rise to immoral minds. So these are the immoral minds they give rise to. So we say greed-rooted consciousness. So in Pali, the direct translation, lobha mula chaita, greed-rooted consciousness. And then there are 8 of them. There are 2 anger-rooted consciousness. So dosa mula chaita. And 2 ignorance-rooted consciousness, moha mula chaita. So there are only 12 immoral minds. So they are all together, the total chaita is 121 chaita. And only there are 12 immoral minds, but they arise most of the time in the wallings. They arise most of the time in the wallings. So now we try to give the names of the 8 greed-rooted consciousness. So by this, by this chart, so the positive symbol, 4 of them, so the positive symbol denotes so manasa sahagatam. So we give you the meaning below. So manasa is pleasant mental feeling. Sahagatam means together with. So you can write together with the pleasant mental feeling. And the negative sign means upikha sahagatam, together with neutral feeling. So when you are enjoying sense pleasure with the rooted consciousness, so if the food is very tasty, or the picture, the movie is very good, so you also have the pleasant feeling. So we said it is somanasa sahagatam. So when the food is not very good, and the movie is also not very good, then you have not only you are watching only with neutral feelings. So there are two kinds of the greed to death consciousness. And also, now we gave you the deity sam. Now deity sam means deity kata samyutam. Deity is a wrong view. Now the wrong view is the you don't know karma and result, or you don't believe in the law of karma and result. Then we said you have the wrong view. No, saha adi samyutta means associated with the wrong view. So no, dejigata, and then we is with yudam. So no, not associated with the wrong view. So no, when you not you perform any action, no, any action without understanding without believing in karma and result, so we say your greed to death consciousness is associated with the wrong view. So if you know the law of karma, and you know that, but you still watch the movie, and you know that I'm watching the movie with immoral mind will give rise to immoral karma. If you know that, then you are watching with the dedigata with yudam, dissociated with the wrong view. So when the bad karma will be weaker when it is not associated with the wrong view. If it is associated with the wrong view and also with the greed, so it becomes more highness. And also there we have asa. Asa means asankarikam. No, asankarikam means not prompted by anybody. No, like the watching the movie or killing the chicken. So you kill it or like you fry the eggs. No, maybe the eggs have the light. Then it would be asankarikam. So if you are not prompted by yourself or by anyone, we call it asankarikam. And if it is prompted by someone or by yourself, it is become sankarikam. Again, when you are prompted by yourself or by someone, so your volition, your action is have less karma. So if unprompted, you spontaneously try to take other people's property or something like that, so it will be more highness. And because of that, we get all eight greed to death consciousness. So we show you the meaning below, or here. So somanasa, we just say somanasa is pleasant mental feeling. Or joy. When you have pleasant mental feeling, you also have joy. And then sahagatam means together with or accompanied by. And deity is around you. Taking that, karma and its effect do not exist. And sambhutam means associated with. And vibhutam means dissociated with. Sankharikam, spontaneous, unprompted, and volitionally active, we say. So kamikoli or volitionally also be kamikoli means active. It's more highness. And then sankarikam prompted by oneself or by others. So it is volitionally inactive. So the sin is a little less. And then upikha is indifference or neutral feeling. It's better to take the neutral feeling. Ekam means one consciousness. So now if you know the name of one the consciousness, then you know the rest actually. So when we read, we say here, No, this is so manasa sahagatam. So no, we read this one. And then deity kata sambhyutam. And then sankharikam ekam. So we say it is one consciousness. Ekam means one consciousness. And then asankharikam, unprompted, not prompted by anyone. And then somanasa sahagatam, accompanied by pleasant mental feeling. And then dedikata sambhyutam, associated with the wrong view. So if you get this one, then when you come to the next one, the name would be the same. You just change asankharikam to sasankharikam. No? So you will read like this. You can read also you can read along with me. So manasa sahagatam deitikata sambhyutam sa sankharikam ekam. So if you get one pair, when the next pair, instead of deitikata sambhyutam, you change it into deitikata vibhyutam. No? Not associated with the wrong view. So we read again, so manasa sahagatam, no? So manasa sahagatam, dejigata vibhyutam asankharikam ekam, and the next one sasankharikam ekam. So after you attain this four, when you go to the next four, you just change this plus sign into negative sign. No, so that means, so instead of the somanasa sagadam, you say upika sagadam. So again you can read upika sagadam dejigata samyutam asankharikam ekam sasankharikam ekam here. And then the next pair, again upika sagadam dejigata, so in terms of samyutam we change into vibhyutam asankharikam ekam, and the next one would be sasankharikam ekam. So you can also know the meaning. So if you take the second one, so manasa sagatam, no, and then dejikata samyutam sasankharikam ekam. So we say one consciousness, no, it is asankharikam, is unprompted, and it is accompanied by pleasant mental feeling and associated with dissociated, no? Not associated with the wrong view. So, no? So you can translate like that. Okay, can you get it? Okay. No? So it's not very difficult. So, no, when you perform the evil actions with the lopa mula chaita, no? So if you I already told you that unprompted, it is more heinous than the one that which is prompted. And then also it is the associated with the wrong view, it is more heinous, and if dissociated with the wrong view, it is less heinous. So when you do the joyfully, no? So so usually when you are joyfully, it is more, no? It is more intense, no? The it is more heinous, you might say, no? The here is less volitional and not active. Okay, so we also have the example here. So the question. So we give you some question here, so that you should know when the great rooted consciousness arising in you. No, if you know that, I am having the great rooted consciousness. Now we give you, a person is, what's that? Enjoying food, no, and drinks joyfully, without giving, without paying attention to karma. So Padvetsa is the name of the Chaita. So actually we should stand from here actually. No? Now we see, no, it's a side. So it's a size one here. So we see. So when here is size one. Now you can name the Chaita that is arising in a person. No? Try to read. Listening joyfully to a pleasant song without giving any thought to karma and its effect. So if you see it is enjoying, no, the song, listening joyfully, no, a pleasant song. So it is enjoying sensual pleasure, enjoying good food, enjoying anything, so it would be, no, so it is no, it is lopamula chaita. No, you know it enjoying sense pleasure, it is lopamula chaita. So if you enjoy, no, the pleasantly, joyfully, so it would be somanasa sahagatam. And without any thought of the karma in this affair, so you have, yeah, you have the wrong view. No, that is the deitikata samyutam, associated with the wrong view. No, so asankarikam, not prompted by anyone, so it is unprompted. No? So, and then the name of the chaita would be, so no, like the in Myanmar we have, no, the examination for this the Abhidhamma course, for Abhidhamma course, no, every year in December. So now Singapore also have the examination center already. No, if you want to answer, you can apply for and so they will ask questions like this, and you just, no, answer like here. Oh, it is somanasa sagatam, deitikata samyutam, asankarika lopa mula chaita. So instead of ekam, no, we have to use the name of the chaita. And we already give that, like when we give the name before, we already give the name lopamula chaita. So there it is understood it is lopamula chaita. But now, no, in this the answer you have to put in lopamula chaita. Now second exercise. Now a man is stealing a handbag after much persuasion by himself because he is aware of immoral karma and its bad effect. So he knows karma and its bad effect. No? So it is the deitikata vipyutam, not samyutam. And then what is his jeta? So if he's stealing something, so what would be the jeta? Again, lopa mula chaita, stealing, no, stealing with greed. And then you should know whether already know now it is the somanasa or upekha. Upekha, no, because he knew about the karma in Risa, so he didn't want to steal, but he tried to persuade himself. Well, you have to steal because you have no money even to buy rice. So your sons and daughters are weeping, no, they are hungry. So, no, so because of that, no, he have to steal. So he have to, no, to persuade himself to steal. So it is, what would it be? Sa adi deitikata vipyutam sa sankharika, no, the so prompted by himself, sa sankarika lopa mula chaita. Again, the full name, upikha sa gadam, deitikata vipyutam, sa sankarika lopa mula chaita. So I give you the 8 exercises. So no, they are for the 8 lopa mula chaita. So the answer I already know. So you try to answer whether it's correct or right or not. Try to do number 3. a lady delightfully put what? Huh? puts on a new dress, but she is aware that attachment to the dress gives rise to immoral mind. So if you know immoral mind, that in the Cho he knows karma and rizā. So delightfully mean, joyfully mean, somanasa sahagatam. And then dedikata, vibhutam. Dedikata, vibhutam. No? He knows karma and rizā. And then, sasangharika or asangharika. Delightfully puts on the new dress without being persuaded by anyone. So it is asankarika, lopamula, cheta. And then how about the number five? A lady is eating plain rice with salt. Not a boy is eating plain rice with salt with some attachment. So we have some attachment, it will be lopamula again. But without joy, so it is neutral feeling, not neutral feeling, and knowledge of karma. So what would be? So number five, no number five. So we say, no, with some attachment, eating plain rice without joy, upikha sahagatam, and then dedikata. Without knowledge of the karma, so associated with the wrong view. No? So associated is sambhuta, the dedikata sambhutam, and then upikha sagatam, dedhigata sambhyutam, and then without persuading anything, asankarika, lopha mula cheta. And the last one, a lady has knowledge of karma, that means also it has the right view. And but after much persuasion from a saleswoman, so persuaded by the saleswoman, so it is asankarika. She reluctantly, so not happily, reluctantly buys a new dress. So upikha sagatam, dedikata has knowledge of karma. So dedikata vibhutam, sa sankharika, lopamula cheta. So if you know like this, okay, you pass the examination. So we go. So the two dosa mula chaitas are very quite easy. So this symbol, the star symbol, we call it dhammadānaṃ. Now dhammadānaṃ is, so the opposite of somanasa. Somanasa is pleasant mental feeling. Dhammadānaṃ is painful mental feeling. Now together with painful mental feeling. And then patika also means dosa, the same thing as dosa. So patika, sambhyutam, no, patika is associated with no anger. And then asankarikam, ekam, no, the unprompted consciousness. And then dhammadānaṃ sahagatam, so again we can read here, dhammadānaṃ sahagatam, patika sambhyutam, asankarikam, ekam. This one, dhammadānaṃ sahagatam, patika sambhyutam, and then satsangkarikam ekam. Dhammadānaṃ is painful mental feeling or displeasure. Patika also being dosa, hatred, anger or evil. So the meaning, so no, you know one consciousness, so no, unprompted, so what's the first one? Unprompted, accompanied by painful mental feeling, and then associated with evil. And the next one consciousness prompted, accompanied by displeasure again, so they are the same thing. Both of them accompanied by displeasure. and now it is dissociated with evil. Okay, we have the exercise again. Now try to answer it. Exercise one. Now, a mother is worrying about her daughter. So what will be her consciousness of the mother? Worrying means dosa, no? It's an anger-rooted consciousness, we know that. So if you have worrying by the poor her daughter, no? So it is asankarika or sasankarika? Not persuaded by anyone, no? So it is asankarika dosa mula cheda. So this is for dosa mula cheda. This is not fixed. Domana sasagadam, pariga samyudam, and then asankarika dosa mula cheda. Now if father explained to his son that not the son had been cheated, and then the son became sad, what type of chitta would the son have? So if he said he is unhappy, so again dosa mula chitta. And he becomes sad because his father is playing to him that he is being cheated. So that means like persuaded by his father. So it is sankarika dosa mula chitta. So the name of the chitta would be Domanasa Sagadam. Padiga samyutam sa sankarika dosa mula cheta. And then we have two moha mula cheta. And here we have the negative sign, that is the upika sagadam. Both of them are upika sagadam. And then we don't have asankarika and sa sankarika here because they are equally inactive. We cannot say one is more active than the other. So we don't put the asankarika, sasankarika. So vichik sam means vichikicca. No, this is vichikicca. Vichikicca samyutam. Vichikicca is also that this is a mental factor. No, this is a mental factor. No, like we say here, skeptical doubt about the Buddha, the Dhamma, the Sangha, and the training is called skeptical, the vichikicca. So many people, they have doubt about the Buddha, the Dhamma, and the Sangha. They say, when we say the Buddha is the noblest and the wisest, the noblest, and then he is the greatest benefactor of all human beings and celestial beings. So if they don't know about the two qualities of the Buddha, they have doubt. So when they have doubt, they don't pay respect to the Buddha. So if they don't pay respect to the Buddha, they lost a lot of they lost great opportunity, we might say. Because just by paying the homage to the Buddha, we get great merit, very great merit. Actually in my book in Kamma, the Real Creator, so it is already been printed by Mr. Lai. So it will be finished in about two weeks more. So. Like a lady, the Buddha, we say he is the noblest because he had accumulated the greatest amount of good merit. And then his morality is the highest. His concentration is the highest. His wisdom is the highest. So he is truly the noblest, the wisest, and he can salvage, uncountable number of people not to be born in the woeful state, and then to attain the Nibbana. So we regard him the greatest benefactor of all living beings, actually. So when we know that, no, if we can develop the respect, then we are getting a lot of the good karma all the time, all the time. No, for example, the Buddha, he looked at the every morning, he looked at the world. Whom he should he should help him. So one day he saw a lady, a beggar lady, an old lady, walking along the main street of the Rajagraha city. And the Buddha as soon as he saw a person, he can read the mind. So he can read that she had done no meritorious deeds. No? So just trying to beg in and then trying to consume them like that. And she will die very soon. She will be reborn in Wopo boat. So when he went on the arms round, he purposely came to see the lady on the road. And he stopped in front of the lady. The lady, she was ignorant. She didn't even know the Buddha. So she was just gazing at the Buddha. So if you develop no respect, no good karma, no moral minds, and no good karma. So behind the Buddha, there's the Mahamoggallana is present. Mahamoggallana could read the mind of the Buddha. Oh, the Buddha wanted to bless this lady. And when he looked at the lady, he could also see the lady would die soon and will be born in the Wopo boat. So he approached the lady and persuaded her. Dear lady, the Buddha, you pay respect to the Buddha. The Buddha is one to help you. You will die very soon and you will be born in the Wopo state. Only then, the Buddha. So the Buddha is very, very graceful, very, very handsome. So only she developed the moral mind, respect. If you develop respect, moral minds arise by many, many billion. So the Buddha already knew. So this is good karma. Usually the karma that you perform near death has the chance to bear result because of proximity, because it's close to bearing result. So when the Buddha went on arms round, she also went on her road with the sticks, the going like that, and then a cow with a small cup. She thought, the lady would cause harm to the cub. So the cow butted her. She died. Immediately she was born. So no time separation. As soon as you die here, so we call it you die because you are lost consciousness because death consciousness. As soon as death consciousness perish, rebirth consciousness arises immediately without any separation in time. Wherever you are going to be born, it doesn't matter. For the mind to arise there is spaceless and timeless, we say. So she was reborn in the Dhammadānaṃ, in a very beautiful the jewel, the mansion, and with 1,000 deities attending to her as her attendants. So she immediately came down and pay respect to Moggallana for persuading her to pay respect to the Buddha. So we have many stories like that. Just by paying one time, you can be born in the celestial realm. Okay, so now we have another question. A further explain to here. No, so here one corner the. Let's call the name of the dhammadānaṃ. Uddhaja means restlessness of the mind. No, the uddhaja is restlessness of the mind. And now the name. So here, one consciousness just as before. Accompanied by neutral feeling, and associated with skeptical doubt, and this one consciousness accompanied by neutral feeling and associated with restlessness of mind, no? Restlessness, sadhana. So, no? As these two chaitas are of equal strength, neither one belong being more, not the more. So, no, the so none, we cannot say one is more active than other, so we don't have any asankharika and sasankharika. So here we have a person who is having doubt about karma in its effect. Now what will be his chaita? So having doubt, so the same thing, skeptical doubt. So it will be just like this. So it is the upikha sahagadam. Here. Upikha sahagadam, vijigecha samyudam, moha mula chaita. And the next one, number two, a person is listening to a lecture, no? But he does not understand a word because his mind is restless. So what is his chaita? So not because it's restless, so it upikha sagadam, udija samyudam, moha mula chaita. So be careful if you are thinking about going home or something like that. you will not understand if you have restless of the mind. So we finished the 12 immoral minds, and we also give you so to taking stock in a day. So if you take stock in a day, what are the minds arising in you? If you don't perform meritorious deeds, only this immoral mind would be arising. Only they are arising. So starting from the morning, we say, even when you look at the mirror, when you look at your mirror, oh, I'm quite beautiful. So lobha mula chaita arises already. So after finishing that, you apply the makeup and the lipstick. Oh, I become more beautiful. And I put in the new dress, so you stand in front of the mirror, try to look at, oh, I'm very beautiful. Then you will come down and you get very tasty breakfast. So then also you enjoy with lobha mula chaita. And then even you go to the office, if you are thinking, oh, I will meet the friend, so we can talk to each other. So enjoying talking is all sensual pleasure. No, lobha mula chaita again. So when on the payday you get money, oh, you are very happy. So lobha mula chaita. So you're coming home. Oh, I should buy something for the family. So while you are buying fruits, with the intention to eat together, so again lobha mula chaita. So when you enjoy the eating, and when you are listening at home and watching the television, or just calling your telephone to your friends just to say hi or something like that, so all lobha mula chaita. How about dosa mula chaita? So if you drive the car, you get the jam there. Oh, you're worried. Oh, I'm late for the office. So you get dosa mula chaita. No? And then when you are late there and in the office, and the officer blames you. Oh, you are late every day. You are going to be fired, no? to be dismissed or something like that. So you feel very bad the whole day. No? So just like we say, no? Like the mother, that the worrying about the children, all those things, so you have dosa mula chaita. No? Also dosa mula chaita and moha mula chaita arise very often. No? So you live only with immoral minds, no? If you try to take note of them. So, no? So, if you know how to develop moral mind, so you can develop billions of moral minds at every minute, every second actually. Okay, so we go to the next group. We call them. So the next, the rootless consciousness. So the next group, the rootless consciousness. No, they are. So the hetu or mula means the cause or the root, no? The root or the condition. So no, here you should know hetu and also mula. Like we say, lobha mula citta, no? Greed rooted consciousness. So mula is also the root. And akusala hetu means immoral roots. And what are the immoral roots? Lobha, dosa, moha. No? They are immoral roots. And kusala hetu is moral roots. What are they? Lobha, dosa, moha. There are only these six roots. No? Only these six roots. So, and consciousnesses without roots are known as ahetuka citta. No? And those with roots are called sahetuka citta. So they are quite easy. No? So there are not 18 of them, no? the rootless consciousness. So we have akusala vipaka citta. So no, you shouldn't have you should know the name now. Vipaka means karma result. No? The result of the karma is vipaka. And kriya is kriya or kriya. It's functional, it means functional. So, ahetuka means rootless, and then vipaka is the karma result, citta is consciousness. So we say they are immoral result than consciousness. That is the direct translation. Immoral, agusla is immoral. Vipaka is resultant, no? And citta is consciousness. So they arise as the inevitable results of past immoral karma. So that means we have performed immoral actions most of the time, and then we accumulated immoral karma in our mind. So these immoral karma, they produce their result in this life actually. And this citta, you will see, this citta, the eye consciousness, ear consciousness, nose consciousness, body consciousness, to be aware of the five sense objects. So we need this consciousness, no? So then we have ahetuka means rootless. Kusala means moral. Vipaka means resultant. So citta is consciousness. So now you can make the direct translation, then you can understand. And they are the result of the good karmas that we have accumulated in our mind. So we have already performed many meritorious deeds. Now today especially, while you are listening to the Abhidhamma lecture, how many good karmas did you get? How many good karmas? So even in one snap of the hand, 1,000 billion chaita. No? So we just say you get 1 billion chaitas, no? In 1 minute, or in 1 second, in 1 second. No? This is shorter than 1 second actually. No? So how many seconds in 3 hours? No? So in every second you get 1 billion good karmas. So what you get for 3 hours. No? So about 1 million. Not 3,600 billion good karma. So So the good karmas are much, much more valuable than American dollars. No, because one good karma can produce a rich the human existence, or a very celestial existence. So with all those celestial mansions and all celestial happiness, so they want many billions of the American dollars actually one existence. No? So when you go home, you can be happy, if you can think like that. Now I'm richer than American billionaire stuff. So don't run away. That is it. So we can get very great karma, we just go. Now we have immoral resultant consciousness, akusala vipaka chaita. So these immoral consciousness, they are essential in our life. So the dhamma, the very result. So you should know chakku means the eye. Chakku is the eye. And sota is the ear. Gana is the nose. Jiva is the tongue. Kaya is the body. And this is sampatichana. Sampatichana, we say it. So sampatichana and santirana. So now the meaning would be in here. So the first one we call it upika sahagadam. Remember the negative sign is upika sahagadam, accompanied by neutral feeling. Chakku vijnanam. Vijnana is consciousness. So chakku means eye consciousness. So we say eye consciousness accompanied by neutral feeling. So if you get the first one, the second, and the rest you can read. Upika sahagadam sota vijnanam, ear consciousness accompanied by neutral feeling. Upika sahagadam gana vijnanam, note consciousness. Upika sahagadam jiva vijnanam, tongue consciousness. And this one we call is the dukkha. Dukkha means bodily suffering. Dukkha sahagadam kaya vijnanam. So body consciousness accompanied by painful feeling. So painful feeling in the body, bodily painful feeling. And then the next one, upika sahagadam sampatichana chaitam. Upika sahagadam sampatichana chaitam. So sampatichana chaitam means receiving consciousness accompanied by neutral feeling. The next one, upika sagadam santirana chaitam. Santirana chaitam means it is investigating consciousness accompanied by indifference. So indifference means neutral feeling. So we have these seven of them. So and if we know these seven, so it is easy for us to know the next group. We call the rootless moral resultant consciousness. Instead of immoral, the rootless consciousness, we now have rootless moral resultant consciousness. So the names are the same. The first seven are the names are the same, just like this. Only this one, the symbol is changed into the opposite one, we call we. So this is dukkha, painful feeling, and this is sukha, pleasant bodily feeling. Sukha, pleasant bodily feeling. And then we have one extra one is the somanasa sagatam, santirana chaitam. So the names are the same, just like here. So the meanings are also the same. So you please read the name. Upika sagadam chakku vijnanam. Upika sagadam sota vijnanam. Upika sagadam gana vijnanam. Upika sagadam jiva vijnanam. sukha sahagatam kaya vinyanam upika sahagatam sambatechana chaitam upika sahagatam sandirana chaitam somanasa sahagatam sandirana chaitam. So, no, this is the result of the good karma that we have accumulated in our body. So, in the Abhidhamma, no, they say, so actually it is written in the next paragraph. No, so we say, according to Abhidhamma, no, one is in contact with disagreeable, no, that is unpleasant or disagreeable, that you don't like, undesirable, no, sense object on account of one's own, no, past immoral karma, akusala karma. So you encounter the unpleasant sense objects because of your bad karma. No, because of your bad karma. If you have very good karma and to be born as a prince or a princess, you will not see the bad things. You can see mostly the beautiful things, and that is due to your good karma. Due to your good karma. No? So if you encounter not unpleasant thing, don't blame others, blame yourself because of your bad karma. you have to come across these bad, not the bad things. So not when, so say, on the other hand, one is in contact with agreeable or the pleasant sense objects on account of one's own, not past moral karma, kusala karma, and at these instances, moral resultant consciousness, kusala vipaka chaita, will arise. No? And then there are, no? Therefore, there are, no? One pair of chakku vinyana, eye consciousness, a pair of sota vinyana, ear consciousness, a pair of jiva vinyana, tongue consciousness, a pair of the kaya vinyana, no? The body consciousness. So these five pairs, no, together are called dvi pancha vinyana. Dvi means one pair, two. Pancha means five. Vinyana means consciousness. Five consciousness that are aware of the five sense objects. No, so there are one pair of five sense objects altogether. There are ten sense objects here. Oh, now the time is up already, so we have to stop. So usually when we stop, no, we also say prayers again. But I think they have to print the you have in your same prayers at the end of the. So we try to see in the chat. Also we have. So we don't have. So we just, no, we what? Some of you can still remember, I think. So we pay the respect to the Buddha, share merit, and also make the wish to attain Nibbana.
Buddham ujjemi imaya dhammanu dhamma paripatiya dhamman ujjemi imaya dhammanu dhamma paripatiya sangham ujjemi imaya dhammanu.
With our
holy practice which is in accord with the nine supramundane dhammas. We pay obeisance to the Buddha, the Dhamma, and the Sangha. And then we make the wish, idam me punyam, asrakaya
maham,
maham hotu, idam me punyam, nibbanasa,
pratyayo
hotu. So we share merit to all living beings. With our holy practice, we share our merits to all living beings. So just say, we share merit to all living beings, we share merit to all living beings, we share merit to all living beings. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.